This is popping off in the world of hip hop. These knuckles, all right? People want to punch people in the face. It's totally a thing. Wow. All right? So, you know, you see people doing well in the YouTube and TikTok space. Now, Blueface is not only going to get into boxing, but it's going to be like this bare knuckle boxing joint.
Bare knuckle
boxing? Bare knuckle.
Wait.
You're going to end up black and blue face.
Right.
No like, gloves.
Oh, hell no.
They had a big championship this weekend. There was like 1,000 fights happening this weekend. Not. So Blueface is going to compete in a celebrity one. He's doing it for $20,000. And you know, the troll
bare
of the internet, Tekashi 6ix9ine, has something to say about it.
Yo, the only time people talk about Blueface is when he's not doing music. So I don't know what you're talking about. Like, who the is Blueface? Right now, right? I got $20,000 in my pocket I walk around with. He's getting paid $25,000 to fight. I walk around with the money he's getting paid for. Yo, you get Lil Durk in the ring right now, I'm eating him alive. Yo, I will him on King Bone's grave.
He's somebody I don't mind being in a bare knuckle fight.
Like you would fight him bare knuckle?
I would get it.
Edge with the smoke.
With bare knuckle.
I think he needs
he
a
He should be in a ring bare knuckle with somebody. Yes, yeah. I would like to see him get bare knuckled.
Yeah, my money's on Dirk in the Tekashi 6ix9ine one. Like, I think somebody who takes that much time getting their hair done, you know, like, short of being a pimp from the 60s, is probably, like, you know, necessarily not like the
toughest.
No,
I want him
dude.
In there with one of the real fighters. You know how sometimes they have you fighting a real fighter?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I want a real one in there with him.
They want that fade. They want that fade. Well, moving on, another hip hop news. All right, so if you didn't see the BET Awards yesterday, Cardi B is now pregnant with her second child. Gotta clap it up for
Congrats.
That. Shout out to people out here working it out.
Baby culture is gonna be a big sister.
Yep, it's gonna be quite the vibe on that. And I gotta send a major shout out to Tyler the Creator, who got extra busy at the BET Awards.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, people came out there, they performed, they had like background dances and whatnot. But what Tyler the Creator gave you was something like, you know, it was nothing short of like a Broadway spectacular.
Yeah.
Like, it made it seem like it was like a scene from The Wizard of Oz that we didn't get a chance to see. Like, the set was blowing and all this other good stuff. And his album, his new joint, Call Me If You Get Lost, which is being excellently narrated by DJ Drama, they say it's going to be the number one album in the country.
Oh, congrats.
Expected to move 175,000 units.
Okay.
So big shout out to the one they call Tyler the Creator getting it popping like that. Also, got to send a major shout out to Cardi B because not only about the pregnancy thing, but she's in the number one movie in the country right now, which goes by the name of Fast 9.
Yeah.
$70 million is what it made over the course of the weekend. $404 million is what it made worldwide.
Sheesh. You know what I love about the Fast 9? I know people are like sick of all the Fast and Furious things, but what I love is that Vin Diesel and the crew, they all are producers on it. So it's like they all make money as producers, not just the talent. So I think I'm always rooting for them. I just go throw them some dollars just because, like, I love that idea when the talent gets to make more than just being a talent. So.
Yo, as a person who's been off and on with the franchise, because I saw, like, the first two, and then when he went to Tokyo, I was like, yo, I'm out, fam. And then I jumped back in on, like, 6. Mm. And then I had to go back and watch the other ones. This particular one... It's something to do, right? Because it's like 2.5 hours long.
Oh,
and then you're like, yo, these movies are getting like really, really ridiculous.
With the marathon, yeah. Like,
then they went into space.
They went into space?
They go into space on this one.
With the cars?
With a car.
All right, now it's getting all right. All right,
it's like, all right, man, I got to head out. You know what I'm saying? And they are going to make another one. Cardi B makes
There's
a cameo. They're
going
to make a Fast and Furious 10. They already signed off on it, so that's
that
on that.
Is that in space? Do they come from space or...
Like, you know, when the movie was over,
they were still in space.
They got back.
Oh, okay. All right.
They got back. I don't want to spoil too much, but it's just like, okay, you went to space in a car. All right, we see you, Fast 9. We see you
in a Hellcat. So that you were in.
Yo, before I go, major shout out to Young M.A. You know, like she posted on her social media that she's battling some sort of addiction and checked herself in a rehab. Now, she always talks about a sippy cup and, you know, she's a Hennessy queen, if they will. So I don't know if it's the Hennessy. I don't know if it's the smoky smoke. I don't know if it's the lean or whatnot. But she's trying to get help. She's like, yo, I'm loving God. I pray that you will comfort me in my suffering. Lend skill to the hands of my healers and bless the means used for my care. So if you happen to rock with Young M.A., give her some positive energy and some good affirmations, because it is one thing to know you have a problem, but it's another thing to seek help.
Yeah.
And I know it's not the easiest thing to do, and I know it's not the easiest thing to share. So for that, queen, we salute you. Hope you get better, man, and find what you're looking for, man. And that's peace, sobriety, and clarity in the whole situation, man. So that's love right there. Anyway, for this and other stories I'm following, you know what the business is. HEADKRACK.
We are the Morning Hustle.